once you see that change is actually happening and has really moved forward, you're almost there. What you need to do now is to make sure that you consolidate the change. You need to make sure that you pour the necessary cement so that whatever you've built is fixed, cannot fall with time or with resistance or wind or being pushed by others. So you consolidate that. How do you do that? A number of steps. You do that by making sure that the structure of the organization, of the country, of the government, of the department, you know, of the entity that you're leading through this paradigm change reflects the change that you want to happen. So there is no misalignment or contrast between the reality that you want to create and the behavior that you want to see and the actual structure of this entity. So you want to change the structure, change it, simplify, add new things, remove new things, whatever it is. I'll give you an example. Take an apartment that is designed for a certain purpose. And now you want to change the spirit in that apartment. You want to make it a more, you know, interactive and open place. Instead of having multiple, chambers, you want people going to their own rooms and staying there. You want people to interact. So what do? You change the structure, as an example. I mean, I'm giving you an analogy. What you do is that you bring the walls down and you turn it more into a loft where you have large spaces for people to be together, right, and interact visually, you know, most of the time when they are in that place. So what you've done now is that you've built a structure or you've redesigned the structure to reflect the kind of environment, the kind of spirit, of paradigm, of mentality, of mood, of approach that you want to have in the first place. That's why structure is so important. There has to be alignment. The other thing you can do is that, you know, the organigram, if it's an organization, the hierarchy of authority, who reports to whom, and how authority is distributed, and how power and access to resources is distributed, is a reflection of this new reality. Because you can't have an old structure and an old organigram or an old structure of authority when you're trying to create a completely a new mindset or mentality or approach or spirit or soul. So you need to change the organigram, and if you need to rearrange people and authorities and layers, you do that. You also need to make sure that the processes and the procedures and the policies are in line with the new reality that you want to create. So these pathways, these roadmaps of how things are done, because everything has a process, whether it's simple or complicated, declared or undeclared, there's always a process the way things are done, right? So these policies and procedures and processes are also fine-tuned or redesigned to match and facilitate the paradigm shift. And this becomes the everyday practice. That's how you consolidate.